continue with sinking fund accounting. Let us do a problem on sinking fund. Write down one problem. An asset was purchased. An asset was purchased on 1st January 2014 at the cost of ₹10 lakh. Having an estimated scrap value of ₹2 lakh. After 4 years, the replacement cost after 4 years is expected to be 12 lakh rupees. Calculate the amount to be set aside from the profits of every year. To ensure replacement of the asset. To ensure replacement of the asset. Full stop. Rate of interest. Rate of interest 10% per annum. Now what will we do is, let us just change the life of the asset as 5 years instead of 4. Prepare asset account, sinking fund account. Sinking fund investment account. For the year ended 31st December 2014, 15, 16, 17 and 18. Did you understand the question? Listen very carefully. Today we have purchased the asset for how much? 10 lakh. What is the life of the asset? 5 years. We have changed it for 5 years. And after 5 years, it is expected to realize as how much? 2 lakh rupees. We expect that after 5 years, we are going to receive 2 lakh rupees as scrap value. Okay? But after 5 years, we know that replacement cost would be how much? Have you written that? After 5 years, we expect that replacement cost will be 12 lakh rupees. So we know that after 5 years, we require 12 lakhs cash to replace the asset. So we have decided every year, we are going to set aside some profits. And that money will be invested in investments, securities, which are going to give us how much interest? 10% per annum interest. After 5 years, we should have sufficient funds to replace the asset. How to account for all these things? First of all, you do calculations, then we'll start accounting for it. Write down calculation of the amount to be saved every year. Calculation of the amount to be saved every year. Particulars, rupees. 2-column table. You'll write replacement cost. Replacement cost per lakh. But here we know that after 5 years, the old asset, when it is going to fetch us 2 lakh less realizable value of old asset. Realizable value of old asset 2 lakh rupees. Next line, you write amount to be arranged by the end of 5th year. Amount to be arranged by the end of 5th year. 10 lakhs. So, when the old machine is going away, while going, it is going to give you 2 lakhs and go. So we require only 12 lakhs to buy. Out of that, 2 lakhs is coming from sale of old asset. So remaining 10 lakhs we have to arrange. Out of 10 lakhs, how much should we save from the profits of every year? That is what we have to calculate. I think yesterday we have handled this question sufficiently. With sufficient clarity. Yes or no? Write down. If 1 rupee, if 1 rupee invested at the end of each year for 5 years, if 1 rupee invested at the end of each year for 5 years becomes 6.1051 rupees, if 1 rupee invested at the end of each year for 5 years becomes 6.1051 rupees after 5 years, question mark rupees will become 10 lakhs. Question mark rupees will become 10 lakhs. How do you know? I think yesterday I have shown, no? 100 rupees will become 610.51. So 1 rupee will become 6.1051. So 1 rupee is equal to 6.1051. Question mark is equal to 10 lakhs. 1,63,800 will say. Approximately 1,63,800. Manoj, do you understand?
You got the same answer.
1,63,800 rupees. So every year ending, we have to save how much money? We have to save 1,63,800 rupees. We have to save at the end of every year. Now, we will start the accounting part. If you want, let us check once again whether it is going to become 10 lakhs or not. Press on button on your calculator. Please tell me when will the first installment be invested at the end of first year. So type 163,800. Please tell me, will you get any interest for the first year? First year ending you are investing and you ask interest, bank manager will show you the nearest door. Okay, next. This will become opening balance for second year. Correct? On this amount we'll receive interest for second year plus 10%. Plus 10%. Okay, hey, wait. Only once. Plus 10% you type. Now at the end of second year, we are going to again invest 163,800. Type 163,800 plus 163,800. Only once. Now you will get the opening balance for third year. How much did you get? 3 lakh? 980 rupees is the opening balance for the third year. Okay. On this amount you will get interest at the end of third year plus 10%. Stop. Only once. At the end of third year we'll again invest 163,800 plus 163,800. Opening balance for fourth year. How much did you get opening balance for fourth year? 5,42,178 rupees is the opening balance for the fourth year plus 10% interest. Plus 163,800. How much? This is the opening balance for fifth year. Plus 10% interest. Something. Plus 163,800. 10,15 rupees. 15 rupees you can give to the manager and come back. So we are getting our amount. Now how to do accounting for all the calculations which you have done on calculator? That is what we are going to learn now. Okay. So let us start preparing accounts. Let us start preparing the account. Profit and loss account. Half page. Asset account, half page. Sinking fund investment account will be prepared in pages like this. Sinking fund investment. Prepare it in side by side page, not front and behind. Okay. This account one page is sufficient, but those two accounts I will now prepare will be side by side. Sinking fund. Very very important concept in accounting. Many students pass out CPT but they don't know accounting for sinking fund and sinking fund investment. When they come to IPCC, they start crying. one full page. Don't do it on Panjus, Marquee Juice. Let us start, everyone. Account entries. Next page onwards, entries. Entries for the year ended 31st December 2014. Year ended 31st December 2014. Please be quick. Write down first entry. When asset is purchased, today we have purchased the asset for how much? 10 lakhs. Asset account retard to bank account 1114. Asset account retard to bank 10 lakhs. Please do simultaneous posting along with me. Go to asset account, write to bank, write the date also. 1st January 2014, 10 lakhs. Next. Write down second entry. When profits are set aside, P&L appropriation account retard to P&L account retard to sinking fund account. This is like a depreciation charge on P&L account retard to sinking fund. How much amount? 163,800. Please tell me, will this entry affect cash flow? Will this entry result in cash outflow? The answer is no, boss. Cash is not going to flow out. Cash is going to remain the same. That means some cash is blocked, profits reduced, cash is there. This cash can be invested in investments giving 10% interest. You'll either buy government bonds giving you 10% interest, or you'll deposit in a bank which is going to give you 10% interest. Okay? First of all, you post it to that entry. Not over yet. Now what are we going to do with the cash? I think yesterday I showed you a problem in which 2 lakhs cash got piled up. 10 lakhs we got to replace the asset, remember? So we will not put the money in Birwa now. We will put the money in a bank which will give us 10% interest, or we will buy investments which will give us 10% interest at the end of the year. Okay? When will we invest the money? At the end of the year only. Because when is the cash available? At the end of the year. Right now, when amount is invested. when this investor same amount sinking fund investment account data to bank account sinking fund investment account data to bank account Come back to entries. Entries for the year ended 31st December 2015. Entries for the year ended 31st December 2015. Year ended 31st December 2015, underline, write down. When interest is received, see the investment account now. At the beginning of the year, what is the investment account balance? 163,800. On that, you are going to earn 10% interest. Calculate interest first. 163,800 into 10%, 16380. 16380, 16380. Write down the entry. Bank account data. Bank account data. Normally, you should credit it to interest account, but we don't credit it to interest account. We will credit it to sinking fund account only. Because if you credit it to interest account, there is a chance that it may go to the profit and loss account. You have to credit it to sinking fund account. Pass an entry. Bank account data to sinking fund account. 16380. Give posting. December 15. This year also you have set aside some profits. No? Write down the entry. And profits are set aside. Every year how much you have set aside? 163,800. What is entry, right? P&L account at R2 sinking fund account. profit and loss account, a cargo sinking fund account. How much? 163,800. Now listen to me. We have received interest, and this year profits are settled out with us. We have to reinvest both. And basically that is what we have considered. We have said interest you cannot take out and enjoy. It has to be reinvested. So yesterday when we calculated interest. So interest has to be again reinvested along with the principal every year. So write off when? I think we have to keep posting to the last entry first. Let us keep posting. We have to reinvest both the amounts. So please add both of these amounts. 163,800 plus 16,380. How much is it? 1,80,000. 1,80,180. That amount has to be invested. Write down the entry. When amount is invested, entry is sinking fund investment account return to bank account. When amount is invested, entry is sinking fund investment account return to bank account. 1,80,180. Balance the accounts now. 1,116 brought down, how much is it? 39,490. Next entries for the year ended 31st December 2016. and fees for the year ended 31st December 2016. Right on first entry. Look at the board. On 31st December 16, we will receive 10% interest on this amount. Right on. When interest is received on opening balance of investment. When interest is received on opening balance of investment. When interest is received on opening balance of investment, you will pass an entry bank account data to sinking fund account. Calculate the amount of interest. It is 343.98. 34,398 rupees. You understood how I got that number?
Yes.
This into 10%. 34,398 rupees is the interest. Continue everyone. Give posting. $34,398 is the interest amount. Now current year appropriation, someone has to be set aside now. What is entry right? Right, then profits are set aside. P&L account data to sinking fund. 163,800. Give posting. Correct everyone? Did you all write it? Next. When? Interest is received. When amount is invested, when amount is invested, see we have now interest for the current year principal installment, both of them have to be now invested. Total how much you can invest? This and this you can invest. Similar, this and this will be invested. How much?
5,40,000.
Hey, you don't
1,98,198.
Write down the entry. Sinking fund investment account return to bank account. An amount is invested. Entry sinking fund investment account return to bank account. 198,198. Give posting. Mm-hmm. balance. Brought down. How much is the brought down balance? 542. 170. One 170 brought down. 542. 170. Don't be in a hurry, but write down entries for the year ended 31st December 17. Entries for the year ended 31st December 17. Write down the entry. When interest is received on opening balance, 54,218 rupees interest will receive. 542,178 into 10%, it is 54,218 rupees interest. Please write down the entry. Bank account retard to sinking fund 54,218. Bank account retard to sinking fund 54,218. Give posting 31st December 17. By bank 54,280. Profits are set aside. What is the entry you are going to pass? P&L account data to sinking fund account. Now tell me how much amount can be invested. Tell me how much amount can be invested now?
218
pass entry. When amount is invested, when amount is invested, sinking fund investment account debt to bank account, sinking fund investment account debt to bank account, two bank, how much amount please tell me, how much?
218 018.
Here everyone, now let us balance the accounts. We are coming to the last year. $118 brought down 10 lakh. $118 brought down how much? Please tell me how much? 7,60,196. Rupees. Is it clear everyone? Next. Now come to 31st December 2018 entries for the year ended last year. Entries for the year ended 31st December 2018. Are you all ready? Write down, when interest is received, when interest is received last year, how much interest will we receive? 76,020 rupees. Bank account debt to sinking fund. Bank account return to sinking fund 76,020 rupees. Next, when profits are set aside. When profits are set aside, how much you have to set aside every year? 163,800. P&L account data to sinking fund. 31 December 18 to sinking fund. 163,800. Listen very carefully, everyone, look at the board. Now I have interest for the current year. I have the installment amount for the current year. Should I invest both of them in the investment?
No.
No, boss. Because tomorrow I want to purchase the new asset. If I invest the money now, tomorrow I have to again withdraw to buy my new asset. So the last installment and this interest, which is received at the end of last year, even if you invest, you will not get any interest because we are already at the end of 5th year. At any moment the old machine may fall down, you would have to run to the market and buy a new machine next place. We are not going to invest this amount in the investment account. Write down in your entries interest of last year and installment of last year are not reinvested. Installment of last year are not reinvested. Okay. Now, I want 10 lakh rupees to replace the asset. Do I have that money? Press on button on the calculator. Press on button. I have interest 76,020 in cash. Type that. Plus, I have the current installment also in cash with me. 163,800. I have this much cash ready. Okay. Old machine, while it is going, it will give me 2 lakh plus 2 lakh. Is the money sufficient to replace? No, we need another. How much? 7. See that number and tell me 7 lakh. 60,000 we require change. See, you have still an asset left, investment. Till now you have put, now we have to withdraw. Dispose these investments and get the money back. Write down when sinking fund investments are disposed. When sinking fund investments are disposed for 7,60,000 only. Let us assume when we sold those investments, instead of receiving the book value, we were able to recover only 7,60,000. Some amount has gone in brokerage, commission, etc. We were able to recover only 7,60,000. Okay, so there is some loss. This is an asset worth how much? 7,60,196. But when we sell the asset, we are getting an amount. But amount is equal to only 7,60,000. So we have a loss. How to deal with this entry? Write down. When you purchase the sinking fund investments, what is entry you wrote? Sinking fund investments account data to bank. When you sell, reverse. Write down. Bank account data to sinking fund. Buy bank. Buy bank 7,60,000. Buy bank 7,60,000 rupees. Okay, sir, account is not tallying. There's balance left. 196 rupees balance is left. There's a loss. Where will I transfer the loss? Sinking fund. Write down. loss on sale of sinking fund. Look at the board. This is the book value of the asset. This is the sale value of the asset. Sale value is less than book value. There is a loss. 196 rupees loss is there. Loss. Normally here to be debit loss. P&L account. Here we are not going to debit P&L account. We are going to debit sinking fund account. So what entry we are going to pass? Sinking fund account data to sinking fund investment account. Right on. Sinking fund account at R2, sinking fund investment account. Now we are posting sinking fund account debit to SFI 196 by sinking fund. Examination question will be asked. Profit or loss on sale of sinking fund investment. How will you deal? You say profit or loss on sale of sinking fund investment will be transferred to the sinking fund account only. Now, do we have sufficient cash? Type on your calculator, type 760,000. Some number is already there in your calculator. Type 760,000, add now. How much you get? Okay, you recheck once again. Press on button. Type, press on button. Type 76,020. Interest of last year plus 163,800. Plus 7,60,000. Wait. Plus 2 lakhs from sale of old asset. 11,99,820 rupees. Some amount short. You can arrange 180 rupees in the last moment and buy an asset. It doesn't matter. That amount would not have been required to be arranged if the sinking fund investment realized book value. Do you understand why we have a shortfall? If those investments have realized book value, there would have been no shortfall. Clear everyone? Now, let us sell the old asset first, right off. When old asset is disposed. When old asset is disposed. When old asset is disposed. Write down entry. Bank account at R2, asset account. 2 lakhs. Video all complete. So now what will you do with the balance? Loss on sale of old asset. 8 lakh balance is there now. Transfer it to sinking fund account. It's only a book loss, no cash loss. Does it involve cash loss? No cash loss. Is it affecting cash flow? No. So transfer the loss to sinking fund. Write down loss on sale of old asset. Debited to sinking fund account. Loss on sale of old assets. debited to sinking fund account. What is entry like sinking fund account data to asset account? By sinking fund 8 lakh. Entry sinking fund account data to asset account 8 lakhs. Sinking fund account will give a debit to asset 8 lakhs. Not over yet. Buy the new asset. When new asset is purchased, new asset account data to bank 12 lakhs. When new asset is purchased, when new asset is purchased, new asset account data to bank account 12 lakhs. Now all accounts have got closed now. Sinking fund account, tell me balance how much is there on the calculator. How did you get that 12 lakh and with the breakup? Last year interest, last year installment, sale value of old asset plus sale value of investment. Last year interest, last year installment, sale value of old asset plus sale proceeds from investments. All of them put together, we were able to buy the new asset. Now, the purpose is served. Sinking fund purpose was to buy an asset. That purpose is over. What will you do with the sinking fund account now? Balance transferred to general reserve. How much balance is there, please tell me? 1,99,000. Transfer it to general reserve. To general reserve. 1,99,800. Pass an entry. The balance in sinking fund. The balance in sinking fund is transferred to general reserve. The balance in sinking fund is transferred to general reserve. Entry is sinking fund account data to general reserve. Please tell me, let us revise the entries once again. When profits are transferred to sinking fund, please tell me what is entry you wrote? P&L account data to sinking fund. What textbooks prescribe this? We don't directly debit P&L and credit sinking fund. We pass an entry, depreciation account data to depreciation fund, and then depreciation is debited to P&L account data to depreciation. So we pass two entries. What is going to be the pass? Depreciation account at R2, depreciation fund, first entry. Then P&L account at R2, depreciation, second. So they'll ask when fund is created, which account is debited, which account is credited. We'll say depreciation account is debited, depreciation fund account is credited. Later on, P&L account is debited. Okay? When you receive, when you invest the money in investments, what is entry you get? Sinking fund investments account at R2, bank account. When you receive interest on sinking fund, bank account at R2, sinking fund account. When you sell away the sinking fund investments, bank account at R2, sinking fund investments. When there is a loss on sinking fund account at R2, sinking fund investment. Loss on sale of old asset is debited to sinking fund. Loss on sale of sinking fund investment is debited to sinking fund. Balance in sinking fund is transferred to general reserve. This is called as sinking fund accounting. Dear everyone, let us do some problems on rectification of errors also. Take out. What do you mean by amortization? Can you tell me? Amortization is depreciation of intangible assets. What is an intangible asset? Listen to me. Listen to me. Your company has purchased a formula from a research company to manufacture vaccines for dengue. There is a research laboratory. They have found a vaccine for dengue. So your company pays 10 crores to them and purchases the formula from them for 5 years. Only for 5 years. Except benefit more than 1 year. Used in production of goods and services. Having a limited useful life. Satisfies all the definition of all the characteristic features of a depreciable asset. So we show patents 10 crores in our balance sheet as an asset. Life is only 5 years. We have to gradually amortize it over a period of 5 years. We call it as depreciation, but specifically what we say is for intangibles we don't use the word depreciation, we use the word amortization. Okay. Patents, trademarks, copyrights, formulas, know-how, all these things are gradually amortized over the useful life of the asset. Are you able to understand? I'll take out fixed book. One more method is left, tomorrow we'll do it. Annuity method, with that we'll do.